Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to fix your Windows search not working on Windows 10. Throughout this video, I'm going to be showing you a few methods that you can use to fix your search on Windows 10. So make sure that you stick around for all of them. And even if one of these methods didn't work for you, at the end of the video, I'll also show you another method that you can use, which is guaranteed to fix search in Windows 10 if these methods didn't work for you. So the first thing you're going to do, if you don't have the search box or search icon displayed on your taskbar, just right-click anywhere on an empty space on the taskbar, go up to search, and then choose any one of these options. It might also be hidden for you, so just choose if you want a search icon or search box being displayed on your taskbar. Starting from the desktop, head down to your start button and then right-click on that, and then go to the option that says Windows PowerShell with admin, or in your case, it might be called Command Prompt with admin, but just go ahead and click on that, and then Windows PowerShell or Command Prompt will open. And then you're going to type the following command. You're going to type SFC scan now and then press enter on your keyboard so the system scan can start. I'll have all of the commands that I use in this video linked down in the description of the video as well in the written guide, so you can go ahead and get all of that from there. But just let this run in the background. Now the next thing you should do is open up a new File Explorer tab and then go to this PC. From this PC, go to your local disk C, then Windows. And then on this list, you want to find System32, which will be near the bottom of this list. So go ahead and click into that. And then once you're in the System32 folder, go ahead and do a search for CTFmon, which is this term. Now, once you have this file selected, right click on it, then go to Send To, and then click on Desktop, Create Shortcut. And once you've done that, you can close this File Explorer window. And then you can open up the run box on your computer by pressing the Windows key and R together, which will open up this run box. And then you want to type the following command. Once you've typed this command, press OK. And then you'll be taken to your startup folder. And all you want to do is just move this shortcut you created from your desktop into the startup folder. Click on continue if you do get any administrator prompts. Once you've copied this to the startup folder, you can just go ahead and close this window, and then you can delete this file from your desktop. After you've done that, open your PowerShell or Command Prompt window again. The scan should be finished by now. And in my case, I have a message that says Windows Resource Protection found corrupt files and successfully repaired them. So to fix that, we're going to go ahead and restart the computer later. But first, we're going to run another command, which is this one right here. Again, you can find this in the written guide in the description of this video. So once you've typed that command, just go ahead and press enter on your keyboard and it'll start repairing. Just leave that running in the background again. Then open up the run box on your computer again by pressing Windows key and R. And this time you're going to enter services.msc and then click on OK. And this will bring you to the services of your computer. Now, once you have this window open, just select any one of these services with a single click and then press W on your keyboard. And then once you're here, scroll down on this list until you find the service called Windows Search and make sure that it's running. You can also double click on this and make sure that the startup type is to automatic or automatic delayed start. It shouldn't be set to manual or disabled. Just make sure it's on automatic or automatic delayed start. And if the service status is stopped, click on Start and then click on Apply and OK. Once you've confirmed that it is running, and the startup type is set to automatic, you can go ahead and close out of the services and then head back to your PowerShell or Command Prompt window. And then you'll see the restore operation completed successfully. So once you've done all of this, you can right click on your start menu, go to shutdown or sign out, and then click on restart and restart your computer. Once you've done that, any search issues you might have had in Windows 10 will be fixed. And in the event that it isn't, you'll need to update your version of Windows 10 using the ISO. Even if you have the latest version of Windows 10 installed, install it again using the ISO. And I'm going to link a guide on the screen now that'll take you through that step by step and ensure that you keep your files and apps and get your Windows search working again. Don't forget to like the video. See you in the next one.